Listen carefully to what God the Lord is saying, for he speaks peace to his faithful people, but let them not return to their foolish ways. It's so important that we hear what God is saying. Why? Because faith comes by hearing the word of God. Jesus said, my sheep hear my voice, and I know them, and they follow me. I would think they should do that. When you wake up in the morning, you should say, I hear the voice of Jesus, and I will not listen to the voice of a stranger. Amen?
Amen.
Are you listening to the voice of God? Because you're going to have a whole lot of voices coming at you in the morning, all through the day. Or are you listening to what the media, what Oprah and all the talk show hosts are saying?
No way.
The Bible says, let God be true and every man a liar. Amen?
Amen.
In these perilous times, it is so important to hear the voice of God. See, when you read your word every day, God is speaking to you. If you want to know what his will is, read the word. If you want to know what his promises are, read the word. If you want to know what you have a right to, read the word. If you want to know what the future holds, don't go and read your horror scope. Why do you think they call that horror scope?
Right,
so,
there you
read
go.
The word. Ahead. The word is telling you about the future. Amen?
Yes.
Psalm 85:8 in the Amplified says, I will listen with expectancy to what God the Lord will say, for he will speak peace to his people, to his saints, those who are in right standing with him. David said, I will listen with expectancy to what the Lord will say. Do you come to church expecting to hear a word from God?
Yeah.
Why do you come to church? People come to church for so many different reasons. But we should be coming expecting to hear a word from God. Amen?
Amen.
God said in Proverbs 4:20, attend unto my words and incline your ear to my saying. When the word of God is coming forth from the pulpit, we should listen to what's being said. We shouldn't be thinking about the buffet. We shouldn't be thinking about what time the football game is going to start. Amen? We should be attending to the word of God.
Amen.
We should be inclining our ear to what's being said. Why? So that when we leave and walk through those doors and get on the mission field, we can have victory. Amen?
Amen.
Don't come to church to fall asleep. God said to pay attention to my words. Go to bed early on Saturday night. Amen?
Amen.
So when you come to church on Sunday morning, you can pay attention to the word of God.
Yeah.
Look at the person sitting next to you. Say, if I see you napping, I'm going to go to crack.
I'm going to go to crack.
Look back at him and say, I'm not going to sleep.
I'm not going to sleep.
And you better not hit me.
And you better not hit me.
Word be to God. Word be to God. We come to church to hear a word from God.
That's right. Going to the bathroom.
Let's look at Numbers 25. Numbers 25, and we're going to look at verses 12 and 13.
Hey, Sherry. Praise the Lord.
And they read, therefore say, behold, I give to him my covenant of peace, and it shall be to him and to his descendants after him a covenant of an everlasting priesthood, because he was zealous for his God and made atonement for the children of Israel. Now, even though the scripture is talking about Phinehas, it concerns him. He was the grandson of Aaron. It is also for us. See, God was pleased with Phinehas because he didn't want the Israelites to worship Baal and Ida God.
Right.
He was zealous for the things of God. Amen. And he hated sin because of his zeal for the things of God. And we should be zealous. We should be eager. We should be excited about the things of God. Amen. We can love what God loves and hate what God hates. We have an everlasting covenant of peace. Last verse, look at Psalm 37:37.
Psalm 37:37.
What is it? I know. And it reads, mark the perfect man and behold the upright, for the end of that man is peace. The New Living Translation says, look at those who are honest and good, for a wonderful future awaits those who love peace. The destiny of the righteous is extremely better than the wicked. In other words, our ladder will be greater than our past. Amen. The best is yet to come. When we strive to live right, when we obey God, when we walk in love, when we are quick to forgive, we can live in peace.
Amen.
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 When we do what's right, when we treat others right, we can sleep at night. Yeah. Psalms 4:8 says, I will both lay me down in peace and sleep. See, because we strive to live right, because we treat others with respect, at the end of the day, we have a clear conscience, and we can sleep at night. Amen?
Amen.
That's one thing James and I have made a habit of doing. We made a habit of never going to bed angry.
Amen.
Never, ever, ever.
Yeah.
Amen. What we do, we use the word of God to settle all our differences and determine who's right. And of course, you know most of the time that I'm the one that's right. And he's wrong. Amen. Romans 5:1 says, therefore, being justified by faith, we have peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ. The Amplified says, therefore, since we are justified, acquitted, declared righteous, and given a right standing with God through faith, let us grasp the fact that we have the peace of reconciliation to hold and to enjoy peace with God through our Lord Jesus Christ, the Messiah, the Anointed One.
Amen.
Let not your heart be troubled. Amen. Just enjoy the peace of God. The word peace in this verse means a state of being at peace instead of at war. There's no more hostility between us and God. Amen. God is not mad with us. There is no sin blocking our relationship with Him, so we can have peace with God. We have been reconciled to God through the death, burial, and resurrection of Jesus Christ, our Lord and Savior. We have a covenant of peace with God through Jesus Christ, the Anointed One, and because it is a covenant, it will never run out. Amen?
Amen.
Give God some praise.
Amen.
So be worthy to be praised.
Yes,
you have an awesome God.
Amen.